The last section in this unit deals with aromatic molecules. So you probably remember from the previous unit that we talked about aromatic functional groups. And I told you that an aromatic molecule with an aromatic functional group has to have a ring of six carbons. So here is a ring of six carbons. And in the ring of six carbons, there have to be alternating double and single bonds between the carbon atoms. So here's a double, single, double, single, double, single. So this is a molecule with an aromatic functional group. In fact, this is the simplest molecule that you can have with an aromatic functional group. That's all it is. It's just a giant aromatic functional group and nothing else. It has hydrogen atoms attached because every carbon has to have four bonds, but that's it. This particular molecule is called benzene, and I'm basically telling you that benzene is kind of the classic aromatic molecule because that's all it is. It's just an aromatic functional group and nothing else. When people were first studying benzene, about, I think it was probably around 150 years ago, they knew that benzene molecules had these six carbon atoms in a ring. They knew that there were double and single bonds, double and single bonds. They also knew something else about double and single bonds. At least between carbon atoms. They knew that usually the distance between carbon atoms, so here's a carbon atom on this corner and one on this corner, the distance between carbon atoms when they were attached to each other by a double bond was shorter than the distance between carbon atoms when they were attached to each other by a single bond. And so when they were studying benzene, they basically expected the benzene molecule to have sort of a short distance between carbon atoms, then a long distance between these carbon atoms, then a short one, then a long one, short and long, etc., etc., because the distance between the double bonds is shorter than the distance between the single bonds. The weird thing was that's what they expected. The weird thing was that when they were able to measure the distance between the carbon atoms, they found out that the distance between the carbon atoms on all of the carbons in this ring was the same. It was th this one wasn't short, long. They were all the same distance. And what this confused people for a while because they were expecting this short, long thing. But what they realized is that these double bonds don't just stay in place. What they do is they flip back and forth. So this double bond might be here on at some point in time, but if you wait around long enough, it will flip over to here, and this double bond will flip over to here, and this double bond will flip over to where the single bond used to be. And they will flip back and forth. This one might flip here and then flip back, and it'll keep flipping back and forth, or it might flip here and flip back. And all of these double bonds, what's really happening in molecules like benzene is that these double bonds are flipping back and forth to the point to, and they're doing this so fast that there really is no difference between these two carbons and these two carbons. In other words, this double bond spends part of its time here and it spends part of its time there. And if it spends part of its time here and part of its time there, the distance between any of the two carbon atoms is going to be the same because the double bonds are sort of traveling around in this ring. So sometimes you can write the structure for benzene like this, where there's a double bond in the northwest corner. Sometimes you can write the structure for benzene like this, where there's a double bond in the northeast corner. And this is just, and this molecule over here is the same as this molecule over here. And what's really happening to these double bonds in the benzene molecule is that they are flipping around back and forth, back and forth. Because of that, because the double bonds spend half their time over here and half their time over here, sometimes people don't write aromatic functional groups like this. Sometimes they write the six carbon ring like that, and then they will write a circle in the middle. And the circle in the middle is basically saying, look, those double bonds are flying around this ring. They spend some of their time here, some of their time here, and all around the ring. Those double bonds are equally distributed, as are the single bonds. The single bonds are also equally distributed. Because of that, I can't really tell you where the double bond is at any given time, and because of that, I'm just going to write the inside of the ring as a circle to tell you that the double bonds are basically flipping back and forth. So sometimes you will see aromatic functional groups drawn like this. Sometimes you will see them drawn with a circle in the middle of a hexagon. They're both just different accepted ways of drawing an aromatic functional group. This act of flipping double bonds back and forth is called resonance. If you ever take organic chemistry, you will learn about this in excruciating detail. But suffice it to say that this is an example of resonance when the double and single bonds swap places and flip back and forth. And it's sort of important for understanding more details about organic molecules and how organic molecules are formed. But again, just to point out, sometimes people call these benzene rings, sometimes they call them aromatic rings or aromatic functional groups. There are many different names for this thing. For the most part, we're going to call them aromatic functional groups. So, just to point out to you, molecules with aromatic functional groups are found everywhere. This is the chemical structure for aspirin. Now, obviously, you can see the aromatic functional group. This is ibuprofen. These are also relatively common aromatic compounds. This is toluene, this is aniline, this is phenol, this is the active ingredient in chloroseptic. If you've ever taken chloroseptic, this is the stuff that numbs your throat. This is toluene. It can be used to make TNT, which is can be used to make dynamite. So aromatic compounds show up in medicine, like they're shown on this slide, and there are many other examples of aromatic compounds in medicine other than those two, and they show up sort of in the industrial world as well. As far as what I want you to know, be able to recognize a compound that has an aromatic functional group, and be able to recognize the different representations of the aromatic ring. And what I mean by that, just to emphasize again, is that sometimes people will draw the aromatic ring like this. They'll draw the alternating double and single bonds, even though they are flipping around. And sometimes they'll draw an aromatic functional group like this with that just shows a hexagon with a circle in the middle. And so either way is perfectly acceptable, and you could potentially see either way drawn out on a quiz or a test. So that's it for this unit. Good luck on your exam, and hope to see you in the next unit.